All right, we are almost done with this isometric exploded assembly. We just have to finish it off. We've got to put in the rest of the hardware and then line it all up with our kind of center lines. It's actually the phantom line though. So the first thing that we want to do is bring in the blocks. And yes, we gave it to you as blocks. You are welcome. Who would want to draw an isometric screw or bolt? That would be hard. This project, if you look where the blocks are, we've already got them in here for you. So let's see. Oops, I'm on the hidden layer. Let's not be on the hidden layer. Isometric layer. All right, insert this. Done. Insert this. Move it down here. Done. And one more. This one here. We're actually going to have that twice. So you could copy the one you inserted, or you could just insert another one, however you want to do it. But these are going to all kind of line up in here. And so all you had drawn isometric was those three views. Now what we're going to do is we're going to get these to all kind of line up with each other right where they need to be. We do that with this guy right here. It is a phantom line. It's a phantom layer. With the phantom line type. And remember, phantom line type is the long, short, short, long. Kind of like center, but it has two dashes in the middle. So let's go set our phantom layer current. And what we're gonna do is we're just gonna line this stuff up. So we're gonna actually really draw lines from the centers. So let's take it from the center of this top one. We're gonna bring it up. And for the sake of that cleat, we don't have room on our sheet of paper to bring it all the way over. So we're just gonna kind of bring it, there we go, a little something like this. What I was trying to say is by the time we look at this in the assembly drawing, we can't bring that cleat straight up. We'll run out of room at the top of the page. So we do have to kind of zigzag it to get it to fit on that page. So, all right, we're gonna do the move command and we're just gonna pick up that entire cleat. Let's do it this way so that we remember, if you go from left to right, you get that blue box and it'll only pick up what's fully contained in that box. All right, and we're gonna go ahead and pick it up from here, bring it to there, trim it out. Okay, so those are exactly snapped to right where they need to be. I am going to draw another line and we're going to take it from the center here. We're going to bring it all the way through. And that is where the cleat pin goes. So we'll move that cleat pin into place. There's not set distances. You want to keep it kind of tight, but you want to make sure that they are definitely lined up with each other. So we can come in here and trim. There we go. So we're definitely lining them up. Now for this one, we'll just go ahead and draw a line going straight up. Whatever distance. This one, we'll keep it a little bit shorter. We'll go to like maybe right here, just a little bit above, because we're gonna bring this. Move command. Get this one looking good over here to right there. Now we are gonna have to go in and trim this and we'll deal with that in a little bit. It's kind of a pain to do that. We are going to need to get this, I'm gonna go ahead and stretch this up a little bit. So we need to get this washer in place. So we can pick it up, use the move command or just pick it up by that grip and then we can kind of put it down here, just showing that the washer goes around this. But ultimately, I'm going to bring this back down. So this is actually going to just go right there. We will have to deal with trimming, but we'll deal with that in just a second. We're going to do another line again from that same center. We're going to go straight down so that we're sure that these all line up with each other. And we're just going to move these blocks into place. So I'm going to do the move command. Select this and I'm going to pick it up from the lowest center point that I can find and I'm going to snap it to here and then I'm going to pick up this one. It's already right at the center point and I will just, yeah, anywhere, just nearest, that's fine. Actually, I'm going to bring it down just, actually, I think I'm going to bring both of those down a little bit. They're a little too close. See how it's kind of cutting into that? But now that I've got them in place, I can just move them. Just move them down a little bit. Make sure your ortho is still on. All right, this looks good. But of course, we don't have the line going all the way through here. So we can just take this line, grab it by this grip, and we'll just bring it to right there. So it's coming straight out of the bottom. We need to trim this line as though it's going through this washer. All right, that looks good. This looks good. What does not look good is this up here. There's a few ways that you can handle this. One of them is super fancy and it actually takes a really long way. It's using a command called wipeout. It just is not the most effective way to do this. So what I always end up doing is I take both of these and I explode them. But watch what happens when you explode. Explode. Look, they go back to the layer they were created on. And if they were created correctly, they were created on layer 0. Remember we learned that in chapter 10. Nope, chapter 9. In our blocks chapter. So we'll have to highlight all of that and then go put it back on the isometric layer. But now we can come in here. It's tricky, but we can come in here and trim these lines. I actually think it's easier instead of trim, 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 trim all the way out. I just pick it up and I snap to that intersection right there. Make sure you're really snapping to the intersection. You don't want to mess up what angle these are. Pick this up, snap to the intersection. I don't even need this line at all. Erase that one out, pick this one up, grab it by that grip and snap to the outermost intersection. Here we go, one more, right at that intersection. So this looks good, that part looks good. Now we need to come in here and we need to trim out all of this other stuff that we would not see. So trim, we would not see the back of this. And then we would not see this. All right, and that is it. We have just finished.